Nigerian governors, after knocking Attorney General Malami, insist on court action over $418 million Paris Club fees. Hello, my amazing family. Don't settle for less only because you are too impatient to wait for the best. Please don't forget to give us a like or a thumbs up if this is the first time. Thank you. The role over the payment of the Paris Club loan refund to consultants is yet to abate, following the insistence of governors to resolve the crisis by litigation. This is just a case of hardened criminals versus hardened criminals. Why is it that in all atrocities in this so-called scam country, Malami's name must show up? Why? Does it mean that there is no file for this subject matter from the onset in the office of the government of the Federation? The original file that was created when the debt and its forgiveness was negotiated should be produced. The file will speak for itself. This is not a court matter. The same thing is applicable in most MDAS where subject file of treatment are not used in disbursement of huge public funds. It's a shame even at this level. Only flimsy files are used and no one, including auditors, ask questions. You can find how public finance is being managed in Nigeria. It is left for Nigerians to enable a system that will ensure correction of these anomalies in public financial management, recover all stolen public assets through corruption, and lay a strategic and sustainable foundation for the development of Nigeria in all sectors of the economy is up to Nigerians. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time here. Thank you. The Nigeria Governors Forum, NGF, after slamming the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Abubakar Malami, over his alleged interest in the controversial $480 million request by consultants regarding the Paris Club refund, have insisted on a court action. According to Nation, the role over the payment of the Paris Club loan refund to consultants is yet to abate, following the insistence of governors to resolve the crisis by litigation. It was gathered that the governors had foreclosed political solution to the matter because the dispute was already at the Court of Appeal. According to findings, the governors met Monday evening in Abuja and resolved to pursue the case for the sake of prosperity. They also said the deduction of the $480 million cash from the Federation account monthly may put some states in distress. The governors are said to be in possession of a report by the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, to strengthen their case in court. A reliable source who spoke in confidence said the governors fed the judgment relied upon by some consultants to demand the huge fees are not sustainable in the appellate court. But please don't forget to give us a like or a thumbs up, especially if this is the first time here. Thank you. The source said, there is nothing like political solution to the case on payment of $419 million to some consultants on Paris Club debt refund. We are already in court. There is no basis for any political negotiation. There is a subsisting court order that there should be no deduction from the allocations of states and local governments pending determination of the case. So, the threat of a garnishing order does not hold water. There are many gaps in this $419 million case, which will soon be exposed to Nigerians. It is a straightforward case. It is about the overall interest of Nigerians, and we must not allow our nation to be shortchanged. It is not a personal issue. It is about our future as a nation. At our meeting, we agreed that we should pursue the case to its logical conclusion. We don't mind going to the Supreme Court on this matter, the source added. We have a report written by EFCC which faulted demand for payments by the consultants. Sahara Reporters had on November 8th reported that the controversial payment of the sum of $480 million to consultants had become a contending issue between the three tiers of government. A federal high court in Abuja had on Friday stopped the federal government from deducting $480 million from the bank accounts of the 36 states of the Federation. The NGF had said the decision of Malami to throw his weight behind the consultants who had been battling desperately to grab $480 million from the accounts of states and local governments raises questions of propriety and the spirit of justice. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is your first time here. Thank you. Recall that some few days ago, the AGF, Malami, said, "I won't sit as AGF and allow governors expose the federal government to third-party liability." Malami wondered why the state governors did not object to the deductions when they commenced in 2016, saying, "Now, nothing untoward happened thereafter, until perhaps of recent, when the NGF was seeking to avoid liability." The AGF said, "The implication of the governor's planned avoidance of liability in the contract, taking into consideration that the federal government was indeed sued as a party, was that at the end of the day, the liability will be placed exclusively at the doorsteps of the federal government, when in fact this a liability that was incurred and admitted by the NGF and ALGON. Please don't forget to give us a like and please hit on the notification button for more authentic news. I'm Ayo Number One News Blog. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.